this church. We have so much talent in this church. I know I'm so impressed. Thank you. You know, it's just so wonderful. And now it's time for our prayer. So if you can kneel with me. You know, if not, just bow your heads. Dearest Father in heaven, we are so grateful today to come here into your house on your day to celebrate this Thanksgiving weekend. We are just so thankful for all the blessings that we have. We have trials and tribulations, but you're there for all of them, and we are just so grateful to you for that. You love us for no matter what we do. We're sorry for the times that we don't maybe do what we should or that for our sins, but Lord, you're always there to forgive us, and for that we're so grateful. We pray that you open our hearts and minds, and you give us the heart of Jesus so that we can look at others the way you look at others and reach out to other people and not be so concerned about our own problems, Lord. There's an awful lot of other problems in this world. We lift our school up to you and all the children and their families. We lift the media center and all the people there that have to face decisions, that you help them with those. We lift all the members of our church up to you, Lord. We all have our problems, and we all have our praises. So those we give to you, Lord, today. We just pray that you bless the rest of this service, and we're so grateful that we can thank you for everything, Lord, and we just are so grateful. But we're mostly grateful for your son who died on the cross for us. And as we go into the Christmas season, help us always to remember that and to remember the true meaning of Christmas. And we ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Oh, What if? Paul writes in Colossians 3:15, "And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which also you were called in one body, and be thankful." What if we were thankful, really thankful, thankful through the trials, and thankful in our blessings, thankful in the difficulties, and thankful when things are going smooth, thankful in our loneliness, thankful in our blessings, and thankful in our scarcity? What if the children of Israel had practiced thankfulness in trials? How would their story be different? After the 12 spies came back and the congregation heard the bad report, Moses wrote that all of the congregation lifted up their voices and cried, and the people wept that night. They complained and said, "If only we had died in Egypt. If only we had died in this wilderness. Why has the Lord? Would not it have been better if?" Then Moses records in Numbers 14:20-24, "Then the Lord said, 'I have pardoned according to your word. But truly, as I live, all the earth shall be filled with the glory of the Lord. Because all these men who have seen my glory and the signs which I did in Egypt and in the wilderness have put me to the test now these 10 times and have not heeded my voice, they certainly shall not see the land of which I swore to their fathers, nor shall any of those who rejected me see it. But my servant Caleb, because he has a different spirit in him and has followed me fully, I will bring into the land where he went, and his descendants shall inherit it." What if, when Pharaoh had poured out more work, they'd been thankful? Thankful they could work. Thankful that they would be delivered soon. Thankful that God had sent them leadership in Moses. What if, when the Egyptians were in hot pursuit of them before the Red Sea and they had held a prayer meeting, thanking the Lord for his show of power in releasing and preserving them from the 7 last plagues, thanking the Lord that they were no longer slaves? What if they had believed that God would and could deliver them instead of complaining to Moses? What if, when the food supply was getting short, they had again trusted and thanked God and believed that God would supply their needs? Even then, God gave them quail and manna. What if, when the children of Israel were in the wilderness of Sin, instead of complaining to Moses, they had prayed, "Lord God, you've blessed us. You've delivered us out of Egypt. You've parted the waters of the Red Sea. You've given us bread from heaven. We are trusting you to provide us water for us, our children, and our livestock. We are thankful for the way you've led us in the past, and we know that you are leading us now." What if, when Moses was on his 40-day vacation with God on the mountaintop, the children of Israel had faith and had not asked for an idol, but had trusted God to bring Moses back? What if they had believed that God had a purpose for Moses in being gone that length of time, and that even in this, they were being laid? What if, when the 10 spies had given their bad report, the children of Israel had responded by saying, "God plagued the Egyptians. He opened the Red Sea, provided us manna and water, and brought Moses back from the mountain. He will give us this land as he has promised." They would have gone into the promised land. They wouldn't have died in the wilderness. The story would be different. What if we were really thankful, really thankful, thankful through the trials, and thankful in our blessings, thankful in our difficulties, and thankful when things are going smooth, Thankful in our loneliness, thankful in our abundance and in our scarcity. How would our story be different? So today, when the mountains look too high to cross and the river too deep and treacherous, and the difficulties seem impossible and impassable, let us thank God for the way he has led us in the past and rest on his promises to see us through to the very end and be thankful.
Amen.
Thank you.
streets of gold and the sea of glass, and I dream about seeing my mom and dad again, and most of all, I dream about seeing Jesus and meeting him. But I wonder if you ever think about the people whose lives you have touched, and about how they may come up to you and will come up to you and say thank you for what you did, because of what you did, I'm here in heaven. And that's what this song is all about. And I'd like this to be our dream today.
Unnoticed on the earth, in heaven now broke the law. Thanksgiving in your heart as you go forward in faith. Amen.